Everybody know that this is my hometown, Atlanta, Georgia, Decatur, Georgia, which is a small town just about 15 minutes from Big City. As you know, a lot of talent comes out of this big city, so sometimes it overwhelms me to be a part of that. A lot of my original family is from New Orleans, Louisiana, which is my birthplace. And every so often there's something that happens in the world that really humbles you. The latest being Katrina, and a lot of my family was affected by Katrina. For me, my music is my refuge. It's a way for me to stay positive. And for 107.9 and the Dirty Awards to invite me out tonight to perform in front of my peers, it means a lot to me, because I think that being a young man, a young black man that's from Decatur, Georgia, for me to be here and for the kids to see me, it's like I'm a living testament that dreams come true. It just takes persistence, and it takes a lot of courage to push your pride aside. You gotta stay humble and keep God first. Time is everything, and our time is now, ATL. So I feel very honored to be a part of this, man. And I have to thank my good friends that showed up: Jazzy Faye, Henry Rooney Lee, Big Zach. I also have to thank my big brothers Earth Guiding and Universal Motown for having my back also. I also want to say hey to my brother Sammy, who is back in the game. We started recording together at the age of 10 years old at Dallas Austin Recording Studios. Dallas pretty much taught me how to make music, how to put my songs together. And the fact that we still here today, that shows that we 10 years strong at only 20 years old. So we kind of like 5 steps ahead of a lot of people, man. And, you know, I just kind of want to show that with my attire too. You know, I want to be a fly young guy today. You know, die that. Thy shall lavishly coordinate thyself. So, you know, I thank you guys for taking the time off. They can expect a lot of different things, actually. As for myself, I'm working on an album that is due in March. On this album, I work with Jazzy Faye, I work with Eric Hudson, I work with Brian Cox, I work with Jasmine, Big Reese. I've also worked with a lot of young people. I think that my MO is to keep the young guys together, you know? So a lot of times, all the way across the board, I just surround myself with the youngest talent that I can find. I think it's nice that we get to showcase ourselves at an early age. That way, by the time we get to be old like you guys, we'll have a lot of experience and we'll be able to pass the message on, you know? I've also worked on a lot of other projects, such as 8-Ball MJG, Young Jeezy's Thug Motivation, Rick Ross's Port of Miami, Lil Scrappy's album soon to come, also Trillville, Tupac Shakur's 10-year anniversary album. And the list goes on and on, man. We always just try to stay fresh and stay new, you know?
That's
Well, I think because our story is the same all the way across, you know. Every city has a Martin Luther King Drive that runs through the middle of the ghetto. You know what I mean? Every city has its own superstars, you know. And the thing that makes us so cool when we work together is that it's different personalities, different stars from different parts of the globe coming together to make one energy, and that's what's tight.
Right.
Definitely, man. We was Green Acres, South Acres. South Acres. I gotta shout out 1B came through, Pimp C came through. Scarface is my older brother. Goodness, he played ball for the Rockets. Gatino came through. The whole neighborhood actually came out and supported me. I thought that was very cool. You know, every hood got a South Side. So it was just from my